The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Different web pages. So it will encrypt, that means it will convert the password as particular username and it will transfer the content in a secure mode. Okay, so that is the use of hypertext transfer secure. Okay, so it will a main question belong by a one word. Okay, so please note it. Clear? So next one is web server to web server communication. So what it will be? That is, if you are using an Amazon online shopping, any website like that, you are ordering the content through a credit card or anything. So the particular bank and the Amazon web server will interact with that, or they will connect to transfer the particular amount. So such communication is known as web server to web server communication. It is an example. Okay. So like that, that type of communication is known as web server to web server communication. Okay. So generally it is known as payment gateway. Payment gateway is a server that acts as a bridge between the merchant and the user. Okay, and the money will be transacted. Clear? So only that message only the user will get. That is, the amount is transacted. Is it? So such communication is known as web server to web server communication. Payment gateway is an important question. Okay, study that. And next is, what are the technologies we are using in a web server technology? We have web server technologies. Okay. So here mainly we have to study about what is a web server and what are the contents which is included and what are the technologies which is included. Okay. And next one is the software ports. So let's do. Yes. So here first one is, what is a web server? We know we have a number of computer systems which is saved in a particular place. And it is stored some data, and if you are requesting some things or requesting some comments from a client side, it will retrieve the content and it will be displaying in that, is it? So it will be arranged in a particular place. Okay. Generally the web server which is assigned in 13 categories or 13 hierarchies in throughout the world. Okay. So here the particular places or the particular sender, which is known as data senders. So it is a dedicated physical location where organization house their servers and networking systems. It is a particular place or in building or in maybe. It is a particular place which is arranged for a. It is generally dedicated for that. It is only using for that particular servers. It is the systems or the CPU or the network which will be placed in a particular place. That is known as data centers. There we have particular storing place and the processing comments or the processors and the amounts which is saved in a particular computers. Okay, and which requires a backup power supplies. Through 24 hours, it's having power supply and which have the particular high speed networking system. Okay, such places is known as data center. So it is also an important question. You have to know about what is a data center. Generally, it is a physical place where we have installed the different computers or the servers. Okay, with a high speed network and 24 hours power supplies and like. Okay, so these systems it is popularly known as web servers. Okay, so which have particular operating systems also. Okay, we know if you want to work in computer system, it needs an operating system, is it? So we have the different operating server systems. Okay, that are Linux distribution. They have producing in particular server operating systems here, Debian, OpenSUE, Red Hat system, is it? And also Microsoft Windows Server and free BSD, that is for iOS operating systems, and Oracle Solaris. Okay, like that we have number of server operating system. You should learn this examples of operating system of server operating system. Okay, And next is about some of the preferred web server packages. So generally we have developing some web pages or anything means you have to access or you have to install such web server packages. Like Microsoft Office, you have a particular package for web servers. Okay, now the examples are Apache Server, Microsoft Internet Information Servers, Google Web Servers, like that you have different sections. You can use that particular server if you are developing some websites. Okay, it is freely available in the internet. Clear? So we'll go for the next software port. So each and every transactions it have a particular port. It have connections. Like if you are connecting in CPU, we have the mouse port, listen, and keyboard. Like that, we have different port. So like that in internet or the server operating system also, they have the different ports. For file transfer protocol, if you are transferring any files or mail means, you have the port 20 to 21. It automatically connecting that particular operating system. And next is about secure shell transaction. Here also you have the particular ports. You can see the different ports in that. You know that what is the domain system. If you are connecting any websites with .org or .com, then you have particular domain system. And also hypertext transfer protocols. Like that you have different ports. Okay. So this is also an important question you will get for one word. Okay. Just go through. And next is about domain name servers. That is it. All browsers, we have an IP address, is it? So IP address, it will be generated with the journey or the nature of the particular websites. If it is organizations, means you can use .org. If it is a commercial website, means you can use .com, like that. Okay, so by identifying the particular IP address, it will resolve the website or it will connect to that particular port and it will display the particular content. Okay. So you have to learn these steps, clear, how we can resolve the websites or the DNS server, how we can find out the particular domain name systems. Okay, here by the IP address it will resolve and it will check the particular local command. We have a local system, is it? Once you have search means you will get the particular ID if you are again opening the particular website, is it? Once it will check in the browser. After that, if it is not finding, it will check in the local DNS service. Okay? And if it is available, means it will display it with the particular IP address or else it returns to that particular browser. Okay? If it is not available, means it will display the web server is not found or not found. You can see that in a web page, if it is not found, means it will display it like that. Is it? Okay, so these are the steps to find out a particular server. And next is, we are entering into web designing. That is how we can design a web page and what are the different categories. Okay, so the web design, popular web design softwares are Bluefish, Bootstrap, Adobe Dreamweaver, like that. It will give a particular options to add any contents in a web pages. We can easily include the website. Okay, we don't need to write all the content or the HTML programs. It is available in an HTML editors. Clear? So generally we have two type of web pages. First one is static web pages and another one is dynamic web page. Okay, so static web page means the content will be fixed. So for example, in our school website, you can see the content in a particular time, is it? When we have to update means, then only the content will be changed, is it? Such websites is known as static web pages. And if you see in result web pages, if you want giving a register number, is it? They will get their result. Another, if they are giving their register number means they are getting their result. So the content will be changed. Is it? So such websites is known as dynamic web pages. In news websites also you can see that the contents will be changing in a particular time. Is it? So such web pages is known as dynamic web pages. Here you can see the difference of static and dynamic web pages. Clear? So note it down. Next is about scripting languages. What is script? So we have learned the functions in C++, is it? So in websites also we can apply the different functions for different actions. So for example, login, username, password you are giving and entering in my website, is it? So we are giving such function to the web pages. So such comments we have to include in a website or an HTML program. Such content is known as scripts. Okay, it's a program code written inside an HTML page using a text editor. We are including inside the HTML program. Okay, so such comment is known as scripting. Script, and we have different scripting languages also. Okay, here we have the different scripting languages like JavaScript, VB script, like the PHP, Perl. For this also we have the different HTML editors. Okay, so we are using the script tab inside the HTML program within the head tab. Like that we can access or we can include the scripting languages. Okay, so it is generally used for the function in an HTML programs for a particular action. Okay, and this is a format we can use the scripting language. Script, which type you are using, JavaScript or PHP, like that you can specify inside an HTML program. Okay, so we'll study the scripting language detailed in the next chapter. Okay, and next is discuss types of scripting languages. We know that we have different type of communication in internet, is it? Client side and server side communication, is it? For that we have a different set of language, scripting languages. That is client side scripting and server side scripting. Okay, for server side, client side we have different language, and here server side also we have a different method of commands. Now let's see. So the script code, it is generally connected with the client server, which generally connected with the web browsers. Web browser. Okay, and here the script is executed in the client browser. Inside, if you are searching some command means, it will be saved in that particular content, is it? So such command is maintained by the client side scripting. Okay, sometimes some content it will not be displayed, some videos or anything. So the browser will be, you have to update, is it? Such command will not be in the particular web browser. So these activities it is maintained in the client side scripting. And server side scripting, it is generally connected with the server side operating system, and it's a particular command. It will be executed in the web server and the web pages, which is returned from the client. Okay, if you have to search in Google means and like that, and research website means, it will be connecting with the web server, is it? So such action it is performed by server side scripting. Okay, so these are common, an example here, Perl, PHP, ASP, like that. And for client side it is JavaScript and VB script. So these are the main scripting languages. Okay, so be thorough with these topics. From next class onwards we are going with the scripting languages and HTML program. Okay, so we are going to the next section of our practical sections. Okay, so note it down, the content, the server side scripting and client side is a main difference, and another one is static and dynamic web pages, and next one is the DNS server, and here it is the data centers and the different server operating systems. Okay students, so go through it. If you have any doubt means, please contact me. Okay, we'll see you in the next class. Stay happy, maintain a healthy routine. Okay students, so see you in the next session. Bye.